Oh, I hear somebody. Is that you, Aegis? We're live. We're live, Aegis. Oh my gosh. What are you doing out there?
Trying to get here.
Wait, can you do your slingshot thing again?
You mean the grappling hook?
Yeah, the grappling hook. Where, yeah. Ooh. Wow, that's right in my chest.
I mean, I have a laser that's local to me.
Perfect. Figured we'd start a little bit early since I was pretty late last time. Spooky. Hey, Diva. Like the gun? Actually, I got one behind my head. Let's see. Oh, thank you for the tier 1 subscription, Dova. Right? Oh, thank you. Look, there you are, subscribing to us so early on. Thank you. Thank you. Wraith already getting into the Twitch chat commands of Exploit. Sani Sensei, thank you for that as well. Thank you for that tier 1 subscription. Whoa! Oh, thank you for the zoom. We're getting a few people to come inside of here. We're starting up the stream a little bit early, you guys. This is going to be a stream where we kind of just hang out with community and check out some brand new Halloween style worlds, as well as check out some new or old Halloween style worlds that were from previous Neos. So hello, Reedon, welcome as well. And Wraith, welcome to you. Hello. Nice to have you guys here early with us. Oh, thank you, Duva, for the 1,000 bits as well. Wow, thank you so much for that. All of the bits that we get. Thank you so much. Good evening to you, Reedon. I'll say like a vampire. To me. Ooh. Didn't expect it to go off. I was trying to de-equip it. Sammy says the chat in game sadly doesn't show sub streaks. Yeah, at least not yet. That would be a really good idea though, to have a form of integration for that. Kind of we've written out just some of our top gifters and supporters that we've had that have given out gifted subs, but we should really have one eventually for, you know, a sub streak, which I think that would be really cool. Also got this spider right here too. Ooh. Try to grab it. Yeah, I'm a little bit short. Rampa 3, hello. Welcome. Oh, we got more people inside here. Hey, Frox.
Welcome, Frox.
Nice to see ya. Cass, thank you so much for the follow. Very kind of you. Team Retro Fox, hello.
Hello.
Hello, Frox.
Hello, we can hear you.
Hello, Rico. I was using the wrong microphone.
Perfect. We can hear you now.
Yes.
It's all good.
Rikio is going to be waking up probably around like maybe 20 minutes, and then he'll be sending us an invite to his world that he's been setting up for Halloween, which that should be fun.
Ooh.
And we'll be relaxing and hanging out inside of there.
Be nice.
As well as, as well as answering your questions for you guys for what's going on for the development on Neos' side, which I'm not sure if we can talk about. One of the things...
sound.
Yeah, we're talking about sound. That's what we're going to talk about this week.
Sounds good.
Yes. Must have sounds horrible.
Kira says, oh heck, early stream, hello. Yes, it's a few minutes early. We are early. That's why we're not going to be starting what we're going to be getting into probably until like 3:05. But yeah, if you're here with us early, definitely.
That's super.
And you can still ask questions here early on in the stream for you.
Probably
you
also
chat.
Spawn this out. Where is it? Oh.
Tatsu.
I'm spawning everywhere.
Thank you.
Fuchs.
There's pumpkin everywhere.
Fuchs.
Oh yeah, why don't you actually talk about that a little bit so then our viewers know what you're talking about, Aegis. Come into the shot and show the camera what you got.
So, oh, whoa. Oops. Forgot I was blinded to my trigger. But one thing that Fuchs is going to be implementing in the near future is file sharing with Aeneas. And within file sharing, it's simply you can not only like save files how you usually do, like importing a model or image and all that, there will also be an option of just seeing it as an arbitrary file. And you can like store things within your inventory or just give it to other people. Like, see, Fuchs is going to take it and just hand it to Nyx.
I'm going to demonstrate how you can share a file in Neos.
Okay, pass it to me. Okay, here you go. I'll say, for instance, that's a PDF file, and he can take it from Neos to onto his computer.
Yep, and this was going to be allowing people instead of Neos to file transfer in a way that makes it feel a lot more physical, and you can transfer out those files out to other people using this kind of way will be a really...
Yes, would you like my JPEG?
This is the future.
And, you'll be able to use Neos? Oh, yes.
Would you like my JPEG?
Perfect. We're using it as the official JPEG icon.
No. But, no. I modeled this.
That's
like
a beautiful like, collaboration.
Yes.
It actually came because like... Hello.
Oh.
Hello.
Okay. You got a popcorn at least.
I think the usual stream treatment.
Let me be sure to reduce down the voice just a little bit for each individual, as well as maybe the sound effects, just so that it isn't so high. There we go.
Let me open up the individual chat window for myself, too, so I can keep out of the
way.
Let's see here, what was one of the things I was going to say about this? Yeah, pretty much you'll be able to use Neos as like a cloud storage, like Google Drive or OneDrive and all that. And to be honest, I'm going to be using it to back up all my files as well too.
Can you turn up your mic a bit, Nex? The surrounding voices are louder than your own, it seems. Yeah, I can turn myself up.
He's also turning everyone else down so that it can be...
It's gonna be really useful, like, this actually came because, like, it's something
better.
I wanted to add to Antonio's.
I'm gonna do a sound check.
Spins. Thanks.
It's like, okay. Something I wanted to add to Antonio's for a while, and, like, because Aegis and Rue, for example, they're, like, collaborating a lot, and they need to, like, share files, like, for example, they have a blend file. But if you import a blend file into Neos, it does a lot of processing on it, and you cannot get it back, like, back into Blender and have all the things in there. But if you bring it in here as a file, then I just can just like hand the blend file to Ru and you can export his computer
and
continue
it makes it
working,
so then you don't even have to use a Google Drive to transfer out files. You can now just use Neos to transfer files and make it very easily to have that out on your computer to work with for Blender or for whatever you'd want for video files or for image files. So
to answer some of the questions within the chat, it'll work the same way as your inventory works. Like, say, this is actually the visual that I made for, like, the actual arbitrary file. It'll show, like, the tag up here. The color will also change, as well as the icon, as well as the name of the file will be underneath. It'll be translatable, too, using the text system in here. And it will count towards your inventory storage. And the storage, in regards to the price or limit, depends on, like, the limit that you have currently. By default, a brand new Neos account has 1 gig, right?
Yeah, 1 gig.
And then it changes depending on the tier of Patreon at the moment. There will be ways to have, like, storage services and all that, and also server services, and that's different as well, too,
it's kind of like
in the future.
Pretty much the same, like, in terms of, like, storage, like, as the existing system, except, like, the only thing about this one is, like, that Neos won't try to, like, interpret and process the data, it'll just import it as it is, as, like, a raw binary data, and then you can, like, just export it back again.
That'll be a very useful
eventually,
additional feature.
One thing I also want to do, once you have collections with Logix, what you'll be able to do is read the raw data as bytes, and you can, for example, write your own parser. So you could also use it as a way to like bring in your like file. So like, for example, like a room file. People are making emulators in NES. You could bring it in as a file. You can drop it in somewhere and just have it processed with logic. So
we have a question from under. They say, is there a way to access it outside of NEOS?
Yeah, not able to export it as anything.
Well, you'll be able to. Yeah, so like you said, you'll be able to export it, but like say access your inventory outside of NEOS, not yet.
I think that's what I meant. Outside, but you cannot really do too much with that one.
Yeah.
But yeah, like, it pretty much it's all like through NEOS.
Duva asks something a little bit unrelated. They're asking, will the INV, which I'm sure is inventory UI, be changing? Yeah, the inventory UI is going to be changed out using the new facet system that of like what we did out for the world's UI or for the new home menu. We're going to be having the same system going out for the inventory as well, to where you'll be able to rename stuff, have an inventory search, and be able to reorganize out your stuff that's in your inventory by dragging and dropping. So it'll be a very nice system for the once we do have that for the inventory. So, good question.
Mm-hmm.
Specs says, are there any new Logix nodes or components relating to these raw files? Question mark.
Not yet. Well, this is not implemented yet. This is something that's coming like relatively soon.
But what Fruits was talking about in regards to reading files, one thing that is a requirement is something called collections. And that's how like data is handled in like a collection, pretty much.
Now
because like the data is essentially like an array of bytes, so like you kind of like need to index it.
Now you were talking about sounds. What's something that's unique that's going on with sounds for NEOS? Right now that's checkerboard for me. The video, but
is it checkerboard? Well, let me try rewinding it.
You're good.
This to the side.
Essentially, like in the past 2 days, like I'm like rewriting the whole audio system for NEOS, because the system for like loading audio clips and playing like a wave and GG Vorbis and FLAC files, it was very ugly, very old, and it just like was really hard to work with. It wasn't also too efficient. For example, like sometimes people like, would import like OGG file that's like a sound effect for a weapon. They would end up like, firing the weapon a lot, and it would cause a lot of lag. And that's because the system, it was kind of dumb. So like it kept like resetting the decoder, and the decoder, that's quite like a heavy process. So I pretty much like rewrote the whole system and made like a set of web classes for handling like audio data with NEOS. Now it not only supports decoding, like different formats, and then like you can either like decode them full into memory, or you can keep streaming them. But also when they are streamed, it actually has like a caching, so like it kind of has like a shared like memory for all the audio clips that are being decoded on the fly, and it is able like if multiple things are reading the same data in a short time span, instead of like decoding it multiple times, it just decodes it once, so it's kind of like smart about it. But it also supports like in memory manipulations. Also like encoding and decoding manipulations and encoding, so you can actually save. And another important thing is that it also supports is the reading for like a resampling. It's using much more elegant system now. So it eliminates a lot of like redundant copies that kind of save the performance, but also it enables new features like pitch shifting. So for example, you'll be able like, to have a sound effect. Really nice. Is this loaded? Well, this one?
And also change the speed.
Yeah, that is loaded for me. Here.
I don't know which one this is.
Here, let me set a smooth here.
There's other fixes as well. So for example, if like a very short sound, like before like NEOS, like you would play it once and it would play okay, but then you play it again and then it doesn't play okay. But here, I'll show the pitch shifting. So for example, now the fire is playing at half the speed, so you can see like you can hear like it's slower. Oh, it's faster. So you can use it like for sound effects, like you can like pitch like over the speed. You can see like the short sound, like it plays perfectly every time.
A good example of Frox saying what this could also be used for is like, let's say if somebody's like pressing more on the gas for a car,
yes.
They could use that one sound to ramp up that level of sound, so then it sounds like so you could have that same sort of sound effects with just using one singular sound using this system that's going to be in place.
Or can use it for instruments, like you can have like a piano sample and then like change it based on like change the pitch, like bass for example, make like some sequencer or something like that.
Yep.
There's another program that I'm showing in a bit. This one, it actually works like with music files as well. So this is just playing playing music. It was too loud. I'm actually changing the speed that it plays at. I don't know, like, you wouldn't do this for music. Maybe for some, like, you're like, going for some, like, specific, like... But let's say this is, like, an ambiance, or it's, like, an engine sound or something, like, varying the speed, it's gonna lead to a little, like, interesting effects.
Yeah, and it's changing it as you're changing, like, the number.
Yeah, I'm changing the speed that it plays at, and it's kind of implicitly changes the pitch.
That's so... so cool.
No, it's playing at like 10% the speed. It kind of sounds like really weird, like when you do that.
Will you be
another thing this is gonna also enable is encoding, so you can actually like or recording. So you can actually, I'm gonna add like a tool. You like press a button. You for example say something, and then it spawns this audio clip in here, so you can actually record like sounds directly in the OS. You'll even be able like to send voice messages through the chat system. So like press something, you say a message and essentially they will like send to the other person, so it's just gonna enable lots of like new options.
Nice.
Someone asked me, will you be able to play it in reverse?
Yes. Yeah, that's planned
okay.
As well.
That would be interesting.
So like for like encoded files, like it might not be as efficient because it like requires like shifting, but like just to work. Let's see. There's like other things because like one thing you can also do in EOS is you can process textures and you can process meshes, but you couldn't do that with audio like audio clips. But now with the new system is actually gonna be possible. So one very common thing that like we kind of like run into is like find like a good like sound effect, but it's quiet. So I need to export it out of EOS.
Sharp sound.
Oh. This is the one? Oh, I think this is the wrong one. But let me find the other clip.
Wrong video?
Wrong video. I posted a bunch in the devlog. These are like in devlog if you like want to have a look at them.
Yeah, Specs was also saying I can see voice messages being popular given that typing in VR isn't always so easy.
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely. I think having a voice to text or voice speech for text is going to be very useful for, you know, just sending out messages to people or even just like having things typed out on like, you know, a board or something like that.
And it's just like for development, like it's really good like to have that flexibility in the code. So another really common thing is like I have a bunch of sounds and I think I'm like looking here, like I'm looking for some quiet one. There was like a really quiet one. It's the short one. So let's see if you have like a sound, it's really quiet. Oh, this is the one, this one. So here, like, it's very, very quiet, you can even see it on the waveform. So now you actually have the option to normalize the sound. So you just click normalize volume. And watch. And it's louder.
Nice. Yeah, that's really useful for like low audio clips. Like, if the clips are too low, then you can just modify them within EOS and just make it so then the sounds are much higher. That's
a lot of like few other options as well. So you can, for example, also like trim the sounds. For example, if there's like a silence at the beginning, it'll like automatically trim it for you. Like a lot of common actions. Like, so you can just do them in EOS without having to go to external tool. And over time, this is more for the future. I wouldn't want to get like a full like audio editing. So you can actually like cut the clips and like do like non-linear editing, apply like different effects on them. But that's for future.
Yeah. MC Gil, oh my gosh, there's so many people joining now. Mick Gill says, the Evolver phone with sound messaging, I see it coming. I see it coming too. Because he said it.
Voicemail system.
Sounds good to me. But yeah, she also says, I'm worried that too many goofy voice messages people may send to each other. Yeah, sending voice messages would be pretty fun too. I would definitely love that.
I can decide not to play them.
Yeah.
Those are goofy.
Okay, you guys. So
we can yell at them back.
So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna be heading into the first world to hang out in. The world that we're gonna be going to is Rukio's Vibes world, or the Vibes headquarters world, and he's decorated out kind of so it's kind of like a nice Halloween theme. And we'll show off some of the items inside there and kind of the stuff that they've decorated out for Neos Halloween Week. And kind of show that. Also, I wanted to apologize. Last week, I wasn't even supposed to do really like Halloween-type themed stuff. I was so tired. I woke up and I was like, oh, wait, we're doing a stream? And I like jumped into Halloween stuff. So really, the Halloween stuff was supposed to begin really this week. But, but all
good. Okay. We're very...
Yeah, we got the early.
Early spooktober.
We're really into it.
Yes. Yeah. But and like I said, you guys, you can keep asking us questions like this. This is great because really what we're just doing for these streams on Fridays, sometimes we just have it to where we can answer you guys' questions and show you the stuff that's going on here in 7 Eos. He's like, oh yeah, vibes. We forgive you. Oh, thank you, Dom. Okay, so I'm going to join directly on Rookie. You guys can join right on me if you'd like. But I'm going to be heading inside of there. Yep, October is spooky month. Oh, hello. Give me 1 second. Oh. Did I crash? That would suck if I did. Yeah, probably. I immediately joined and then it's just like, ugh! Give me 1 sec, you guys. Yes. It did that. My apologies, stream technical difficulties. My apologies. No, don't exit. It did oof me. It oofed me big time. Can't believe it. I guess we're just gonna have to switch this over to the next Selenia SMR stream now. Okay, back and intact. Let me switch over back my camera. Ding 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 ding, and I'll rejoin back on Rukio. And there we go. Hopefully I'll reload us back inside there this time.
Oh god.
Oh god. I'm doing great, Will.
Welcome back, Max.
Yes.
You're out. You're out cool, aren't you?
White theme desktop. Oh, I don't have a white theme desktop. Okay. I have permissions to get my avatar, right?
Yeah, you have permissions before you even loaded him.
What? Oh, cool. Hush you. Hush you. I'm so tiny and small right now, too. Oh, there we go. You're better.
Everyone except you, Nyx.
Yeah, everyone except me. Hello, princess. Nice to see you. Hugs. Nice to see you, princess.
I hate it.
Hey, Brooks. Brooks.
Well, hi.
Hey.
What's going on?
So, I wanted to show off first, you got some candy here for us, right?
That's all yours.
Oh, thank you, dude. We got some free candy, chat. Let's get it. Oh no. No candy for us, I guess.
High five.
So one thing that happened earlier, I was trying to reach for it. As soon as it did that, I touched my desk accidentally and I was like, what?
But yeah, they definitely have some fun interactive Halloween items that Rukio and the boys made out. And the girls.
I gotta say that one is from the Creator Jam.
Yeah.
Which Creator Jam was this one from? A recent
it
one?
It was from a remix of the Corn Maze.
Oh, of the Corn Maze? Oh, nice. I love that so much. Also got this thing. Was this one from a Creator Jam too?
Yeah, I've made that one in there though.
Technically, it is. One in the.
Yeah.
Nice, and you also got it themed up to where the music is linked up.
Yeah.
To the React of the Emissives, which I really love.
Yeah, so all the inside of the pumpkins are actively vibing to me.
You sound so tired, Rukia.
this is real me. This isn't me when I'm.
This isn't my, real me.
The utmost of hype. this is a little.
Fair enough, dude. You sound good though. Is he still up? Did he not go to sleep? He did go to sleep, but he kind of woke up after he was asleep for like 2 hours. So, thanks for that.
Yeah, no problem.
Use your voice. I think you should. You know, what you need to do is you need to go in as a voice actor while you're sleep deprived. And then you have your voice like that, and then they'll hire you immediately. They'll be like, "Yes, we've been looking for a voice just like this." In fact, he's sleeping right now. Yeah, he is sleeping right now. He's sleepwalking. He's good. We also got this nice blood waterfall going down here. In a spooky boat. Oh yeah, let's jump in. Whoa. Excellent.
Just lay back and relax and just carried by the stream. Or it could be what is it called, like you know that drink you mix with water and becomes
whoa.
Like red.
Fruit punch. Hello. Whoa. How do I get out? I don't
what
like
flavor?
It. Here I am.
There's a lantern.
Oh, there's a ladder. I said lantern.
So, what flavor is this? Cherry, wild cherry.
Thank you, Laz, for the raid. Thank you.
Fruit punch.
Very kind of you.
How many flavors are there? It is red licorice.
Mm-hmm. It's cherry flavored. Don't worry, you guys. Cherry flavored. Mmm. Delish.
Wait, red licorice is cherry
oh,
flavored.
Oh, there's like a little tunnel.
Usually it's strawberry.
I like this.
Oh, raspberry. One of those.
Oh, yeah.
That's kind of how my girls.
Actually, can
Titan,
I?
Titan, hey, welcome.
This? Yes.
Let's have here.
At any point, Max, if you want me to explain like the map and like different mechanics we have here?
For sure, Sleepyhead.
The ladder's here.
Sounds good to me.
This is the real.
Alright. So I guess we should start from the top, huh?
Yeah. Let me see what you got, dude.
Sure. Do you wanna grab let's see, okay, so there's an Aegis. Do you want to grab Fruks and the rest of them, or are they just chilling and walking around?
I'm sure they're fine.
Alright.
They're checking out the place on their own.
Yeah, no problem. Oh, I see her. Yep, there they go. They're running off over there.
And here we have a wild Fruks and Veer crossing the field.
So, ever since the Creator Jam, we wanted to, make a credit board would be a lot easier to kind of rep people. So this was done by a combination of Toxic Cookie and Small Cookie. So a combination of the cookies is easy as like clicking the green button, your name pops in, you can put whatever message you want, as in I did this thing or hello. And now it's just so much easier for people to add themselves to the boards and have the ability for them to just dynamic add themselves for whatever. For example, the Meta Movie Guys allowed us the ability to use certain models. I'll have to update it to the current written music, but given the area where I'm getting the music from, Hex Hands, the Archulus is doing a lot of different panels for us and helped us out a lot. And just things around the map. So this was super important. This is one of the first things we got made, besides the structure for the map.
Yeah, because right now this whole world is going to be kind of like your guys' hangout area or your main hub area for collaboration and building out more worlds that you guys are going to be doing out, right?
Yeah, this is.
But right now it's kind of decorated out in the way of the Halloween theme, which I think is a really cool idea. And there's other areas as well that since I'm here as well that people have built out. Why don't you show those areas out? We got a theater area. Why don't we show that first?
Sure. So this is all ghetto.
All ghetto. Yeah, it's still work in progress.
Yeah.
Using that Minecraft
teleporter.
Yeah, but yeah, that Minecraft teleporter. Let's go.
I don't know why I teleported you over there. That's fine.
Because it's me. So we have our theater. It's still work in progress, but we have. I can just copy and paste this thing here, unless you have a specific thing to show them.
The theater intro video.
Wait, we have a theater intro video? What?
I did, but it got cleared.
Oh.
Is it music?
Yeah.
Is this copyright stuff? Should that be looking at
this? This is, no, you can't even hear right now. The audio is,
But don't look at it.
no, you're fine. It's a trailer. It's a trailer.
It's a trailer.
So we've got the button so you can turn off the lighting that comes off from the side from the screen, for example.
Oh wait, I need to reverse that. That's supposed to be all
And you're gonna be doing a lot more editing, I'm guessing, to this world, having the projection, I'm sure, going through and some different effects for sound effects, I'm sure, as well.
Yeah, at least it's pretty placeholder, and I was mostly just getting the functionality working first.
Yeah,
that's what I was looking for, placeholder. But Ghetto was holding me pretty well there. that's why my brain's not working right now. So, and then we like the idea of the seats, you'd be able to lift up the armrest to make a longer thing. So if for people me to lay down. You just be able to lay across multiple chairs.
Yes, nice and relaxing. I'm loving the metal.
Yeah.
These hard ting 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 metal chairs.
All
it's good.
These are placeholder too. I'll
sit in my IRL chair.
These off of seats comfy. That are in on the theater near me.
So this way we'd be able to hold events just being able to chill with our team members, our friends, come in here, watch movies or videos, or just kind of have an area we can kind of collect and come to. But yeah, you are right. We want to have some more areas inside the theater here. That way.
Before there's going to be a little control panel area that's going to be right here, right?
Yeah.
Where you can control it.
We're actually thinking about having stairs kind of going up, and then it's just a little room up top. So it's almost you're actually a movie theater. So it's looking out towards the actual screen.
I was going to put a projector up room up there with a control panel.
He's got the brain cells right now. There you go. Those are the words that I was wanting to say.
Yeah, like an and actual projection box.
Projector. It's really heavy, but.
But yeah, let's check out some more areas.
Sure.
That you got over here instead of your Vibes headquarters.
All right, so we got, don't mind the temporary daytime skybox.
Yeah, this isn't really spooky. Boring. It's supposed to be Halloween themed. What you doing?
hey, you're right. Let me we'll jump in here real quick.
Oh, we got arcade vibes right here. Here, let me do a zoom in on that sign up there. There you go. Even got like a little Neos logo on it. That's pretty cute. Ooh.
Hello. So the. Oh, let me just do this. Let me just use our thing here. Set night.
Oh, thanks.
All right, there we go. Same with the night. Let's put this.
Want to play some air hockey, Beamed?
Hell yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna win.
Use your lasers.
Are you winning?
Oh my god. Oh my god, use your lasers.
Are you winning?
Are you winning, son?
So we've got two combos.
Hey! One is zero. Let's go.
So we've got two areas we can come into. You notice at the door there's even an eyeball.
Oh, Bean! You hit your hand there, boy. Oh. Poor Bean.
Oh, no.
You hurt himself. He went way too ham there, too early. Too ham, too early, boy. 2-0, let's go.
I thought
that was the CP1. Well, my play space effort.
Oh no.
Walls win.
Yeah.
Sorry, Bean. Do you mean to make you go try hard?
No. I keep jumping.
But we really wanted an area where people could like come to. So what we did is when you enter this this building, it puts you under non-persistent parents of your name. There you go.
Hey! That's cheating! Fine, you wanna do that? We'll go. If you wanna laser it up in your beard, we'll go.
Oh my god, this is extreme air hockey. I don't know what I'm looking at right now. That's like, it's what I can only assume was esports level of air hockey. What side is
just so you guys can
anymore?
See, this is what my laser is looking like as I'm going all over this. Definitely not the way to play, but it is the way to play. Hey, it's working.
Oh no.
It's working.
Alright, where's this reset?
GG.
Do you see the score up top?
Mm-hmm. I thought you were flipping me off for a second. I would have laughed.
Do middle finger.
There we go.
Laughed so hard. If you gave me the middle finger right there.
There we go. We set the score. And then we've got.
And y'all's got this. This one from the from Gones and.
Oh yeah.
And Kubot or
Komashiba.
Komashiba's.
Yeah, see, they gave us permission.
MNC. Awesome.
I've been talking.
I'm sure when there's more emulators inside of Neos and even more games and more crazy stuff, I'm sure you'll add inside of this room and it'll be.
Yeah, Bean wants to redo his Stack'em. Gina, I think, was looking into making like a pinball machine.
There are a bunch of machines on my list.
Yeah,
video poker.
Yeah, the video slots. Poker. Just,
but it's not arcadey, but I guess maybe.
I mean, it's still some
attracts
people. Yeah. The idea is the games will attract people to come into this building, and then when they put like videos or they spawn toys or whatever, they're in this room that's all non-persistent, so we don't have to worry about their mess. The good part is if you see the eyeball over there, you can even click that and it'll turn off everybody that's not inside this room.
Nice, so let's actually like see that real quick. So if I click on that, it's going to de-render out all the other people and the other stuff that's out there.
Yeah.
Which, that just then, like, boosts up your frame rate as well.
Exactly.
Which is pretty good.
And then...
Hoi hoi, Draken. Hoi hoi.
Click that again. There actually even is an eyeball here.
Oh, it left my camera there, though.
Oh, yeah. If it's not, like, attached to you in third person...
Let me... Let me grab the camera. Let's go.
you gotta keep an eye on that thing.
Okay, all good. Whee!
So like we have like an eyeball from each part of the middle. Mm-hmm. So this allows you to render people that are inside the area, or just be like, no, we're fine. And then you can de-render that.
Nice. I also wanted to show, instead of your world, you've gotten shadows really nice. Look at the ground, you guys. He actually has the shadows on those trees that are up there, or the tree that's up here, with the leaves waving in the wind, to where the shadows make it look like you're actually kind of like looking at trees waving in the wind, almost like IRL. Looks pretty crazy.
Mm-hmm. And then, shout out to Frooks for... fixing up the displacement shader. That's why we have the ability to have, say, like, the leaves move like this. This isn't a wiggler, it's not moving the mesh.
Always shout out Frox.
It just allows the world to look that much better. So, for example, like the grass, which if you get close enough, you can hide this panel. The grass.
I do have to say, I'm guessing a lot of the UI stuff is Toxic Cookie doing his stuff.
Heating.
Oh, he did out this one? Yeah, to say, all of the UI stuff inside of here is so, like, you know, amazing to see, like, a stuff, even the visualization of, like, walking towards it, and it just peers out like that, and I can have these different settings, and it's a really just a great use of, like, UIX. Can turn off the shadows. Which you're not having, like, physical buttons, which is saving a lot more in performance when you're using UIX for a lot of stuff.
Yeah, so, and it looks a lot more clean, so... I mean,
definitely.
So, you know, you can see, like, we've got, like, a few different, like, hangout areas down here. The whole premise is just for people to come out here and chill. But, like, we have our mirror over there for people who need to see their mirror
They need to see their mirror and their camera.
Yeah. Oh, there's
one. I turned it off because I was trying to figure out where frames were going.
Frames. We don't need no mirrors. If you're looking at the mirror, you're missing all the beauty.
Definitely. So the ultimate idea of the world was we wanted our team members to, like, those who were able to create things. But at the same time, so that everybody would be able to come to one area, right? So people who know how to make things work using, like, logics, but didn't know how to create an environment. I was hoping that we would have, like, an HQ that everybody would enjoy. We've got different work areas, which we'll visit the other one here shortly. And, you know, after just, like, a couple hours, the next day, everybody just started pitching in here. Like, we have our entire team here, like, their time zones, what day it is. We've got it separated for, like, Americas, EU, Australia. I can even, like, click the V, and I'll actually highlight now which one, of our team members are in the world with us right now. So, this section of the map allows us to get a bit more productive. We have our time zones. Say if Hedy comes in.
Which for collaborations use, this is so helpful and useful. Also, Power Anger, thank you so much for the follow as well.
Mm-hmm. That was the biggest thing. Yeah, like, just exactly like I said. It's like, why is Rukio not on at 7 p.m.? It's time to blow up his DMs or something.
Yep. So sounds good to me.
Yeah, that's how it goes, right?
He doesn't need sleep. I mean, you're awake right now. Only 2 hours to let's go.
I fixed my sleep until I don't get this thing anymore.
Dova says to tell you that he said hi.
Oh, wait, who said that?
I don't know how it works exactly. Because I'm currently
But yeah, so he didn't let you get on, but okay, what are some things that need to be done? So we actually have a list of different things that might need to be done. So he might come over to, okay, well, what's Rukio want done? Or what
so he decides it.
Cinema's kind of like. Or weather system noises.
PD might
go, okay, well, I can do that. Go and get it all set up, and then check it off, and then you can see, using Smoke Cookie's VR to list, like, to-do list, we're able to, like, see and show what things we have, like, completed. Right?
Yeah, and you can do like a little checkmark list for tasks. That's really nice.
Exactly.
Okay, that's
another one. So this way people can be productive, and if they don't have any ideas, they can pull from this board. Or people can be like, okay, well, this is currently what insert person is working on.
Oh, well, then I'll be cracking my knuckles and just typing away all the ideas. Let's go.
Yeah, exactly.
Kick my feet up, crack my knuckles, and let's go. Ideas.
Yeah, it's like, what can I get out of here?
Weird things that happen.
Alex made the time panel, of course. Then you've got like a little picture board here.
We're going back to that meme. No, I'm joking. Beautiful. The truth will set you free.
That's a good one. Reminds me every day to the high last.
Reminds you every day to what? To release a world? You better.
we're close to releasing.
I love your Halloween.
Oh, thank you. I love your Halloween outfit as well.
Thank you. I just slapped it on. It's nothing special.
I did change a few things.
Yeah.
Wait. What's your Halloween outfit? Beautiful. I forgot about that. That genuinely scared me right there for a second.
Wait, I was like, oh my god. I was like already wondering if my audio was broken, but I still had your stream running on like very quiet audio. I was like, what the fuck is this?
You like the money,
bro. Is that what that is?
So Rukio, I also wanted to ask, there was another area right there. Is it okay if we show that on stream too? What you got built out over there?
We can go to everything.
Here, let's head out over there. Also, if you guys have any questions for Rukio or any people that have been helping out to make this world, you can ask questions in chat too, and, you know, ask them any questions if you like, or even just us on the Neos team for questions that you guys might have.
Rukio, can I say I like this?
Yeah, this is really this is my chill area right here for sure. I want this in real life.
This was actually a joke.
No, that's a smart idea. This is brilliant.
It's just some lighting and it'll be good.
Like you can put your water, like you can dip your feet with like in the fountain with the water and just relax and like sit here and listen to the water of the fountain going down. It's perfect.
I mean, explains why the wood is a little bit, you know, that's seen the better days.
This is oh yeah, it's got some moss all over it. That's okay.
Yeah, this is the. I think Alexa coined this as the water cooled gazebo.
Yeah, it reminds me of this hotel that I stayed at before, where they had a lake in the back part of the lake, and they just had chairs and like lawn furniture all in the lake, and you could just like sit out there and relax on the lake, but you're sitting on furniture.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, that's kind of cool.
But this would have been much better because it has like a little roof over it.
Oh, you have the right idea. There you go. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Just some lighting to at
Speaking
least like.
Speaking of water, I think I'm gonna dump my body in the river for a bit and eat my food.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Only one way of wording it, but.
That's one way of saying it.
Yeah. That's one way of going in your cave right the there. Once we get physics and ragdolls over.
Oh, so you also got another thing over this way. Talking about physics, got the basketball court here.
Yeah.
Am I gonna be slam dunk?
Yeah, you are.
I guess no clip. Once we get the physics, no clipping on the ball court, right?
No, just kind of like under the leg, around the back.
Yeah, just like no lasering your ear hockey.
I mean, I think it kind of works. Yes, laser ear hockey kind of works.
Hmm. Mm-hmm. Hey, well. It ruins it.
Honor system, I get it.
Yes, honor system.
So, like, with the, our lights and whatnot, our main thing is with our day-night cycle, we want to actually tie things to it. So if you watch, like, the lights here or the street light lamps behind me, if we go ahead and set it to daytime, you'll see that temporary sky, but you can see all the lights are actually also turned off. Even some people have their models tied to the day-night cycle, so when it becomes nighttime, like the little emission or their just like different parts of them start to change. So like if A just wanted to, you know, if he got with us about the day-night cycle, he could have it whenever it's nighttime. He just like have a bunch of like lights and just like things kind of like that trigger on. With them, just using the power of dynamic variables. It's nice. Just easy, just plug and plug and play.
Yeah, yep. Plus this, Corey, I really like that you're constantly extending out and building out outwards from, like, that one center hub area to, like, outwards to these, like, little places that, you know, you can just, like, hang out and have fun in and just do different stuff, which...
Oh, definitely.
I'm pretty sure we'll be having physics, hopefully, by the end of this year, and once we get that... situated through, that would be incredible.
Let me in.
Oh, you got your vibes fence.
Absolutely right.
The vibes fence.
This is something that just figured we'd quickly whip up. Princess Wedding.
No, Gory, you stay behind the fence.
Behind
the fence, Gory. No, no,
actually,
hop
what
in
you
the
do,
fence.
You put it in the center of the court, and you have volleyball.
Let me in.
There you go. Yeah.
You even more so behind the fence. Eat Gory first.
Hold on, I got this. Why is it not working? I need Pack-a-Punch, guys.
Why am I not surprised? It's another day in the house.
We still need them to put the top here for the
poles.
Turn under those
for
4K.
Yeah. So these are areas that aren't built out yet, so the park area wouldn't look like this, so the basketball court, we might change up a bit more. All just kind of like a visualization to kind of like help push morale forward. Because when you, as you see things.
Oh, so Shorty
become...
made this ball cart?
Yeah, so Shorty made this, yeah.
Oh, proud of you, Shorty. Did a great job. Really good job. I love the ball court. We need this. Oh, we need more space and more times that I can hear Bean just like slap his desk and just go.
Yeah.
Those are my favorite.
The general like idea of this is to be have like a plaza-esque city. So
hey, I'm just glad that you put a tree in the center and just not like a statue of your head. Just
no,
like in the center.
No.
You did that,
I wouldn't do that.
Then I would have been cracking and laughing and giving you so much shit if you did that.
I'd get so much shit. No, but it's like I said, it's not just about
you
me.
Can
it's about
from vibes.
Yeah, we can like swap out. Yeah, definitely get some different things going on.
Rukio's Egotorium.
No. We don't need that. No, there's no Egotorium. Minari, please.
He's like, Minari. Let's put a statue of Rukia somewhere. XD.
No, statue. I'm vetoing the idea. There's no statue.
But can it be one of those angel statues that kind of have like the waterfall?
Statue with Rukia's head on it.
It's just your mouth.
No statues.
He's like, no statues. Okay. Oh yeah, this actually.
So here we walked in to a wild Frickson Rear, but this would be like the logics area. So yep. We have
high
verticality
with a fish.
So like when people like Earthmart brings out his big brain logics, that's like a wall. You have the room to actually see what's going on.
Do you mind if I bring a Twitch chat here?
Sure, yeah, sure, whatever.
Cool. Twitch chat, I'm bringing you out so you can use Twitch Shackmans if you want.
Big gangs.
Oh god.
Oh boy.
Bring in the Twitch gang here. Let's go. Excellent. Okay.
But yeah, because so it... same premise. Immediate.
We are uncaged.
Oh my god.
My sides are hurting.
Man.
Come back, Rukio. Poor Rukio. Whoa, thank you so much, Snooper, for the 5 gifted subs. Very kind of you, my dude.
I believe I'm getting bullied.
Yeah, no bullying, you guys. I gave you this ability to do this to chat. You gotta. Yeah, well, he did over us, yeah.
You really
love
me.
Yeah, that's not fine. Alright, so, that's right. I got all the subs kind of sitting around, too. That's nice. I like that.
Yep, the sub follows us around.
Heck yeah. So, same premise again, right? You have the eye, so if you're working on logics, you want some frames, or you just want to be able to turn off what's going on, you could actively just go in and you hit the eyeball. Everybody that's outside is now pulled, everything that they've spawned. Oh, thank you. Everything that's spawned in, you don't have to worry about. And you can kind of like work in peace. You just have the music going on
so
in the background.
So you just click on this. I want to cuts out a lot of the other stuff that's out over there.
Yeah.
Nice.
So, eventually I'll probably see about having some sort of physical. Maybe like these like front panels will be a different material, so it blocks out. Have an actual door. And what we can do is when you're inside here, we can utilize that block off as. Cutting out different areas of the map that you wouldn't need to see, and then giving you extra frames.
Nice.
Kind of like how we have with like the arcade.
Also, if you guys thought that was pretty funny, definitely leave a clip for us and clip that of
Explode. Is that what we're doing, Chad? Is that what we're doing?
Clip all the things.
You love me.
Hey.
Mm-hmm.
It's good. Yeah. It's good content.
Oh, hell yeah! No, I feel that. But yeah, so this is definitely like one of our bigger areas. It just allows people the ability, relatively, to work on models and work on whatever like things they want to inside here. Oh no.
Also, why don't you guys give us some pumpkin heads as well? You can type in !! Pumpkin and put a space and the username. The pumpkin one is only going to last for a little while inside of the chat for the Halloween theme. So, or well, you can just give me a hat too. Sure, no, that works. It's pumpkin, right?
Welcome back,
here. The pumpkin.
Did they spell pumpkin right? That's right. That's how you spell pumpkin. No.
Delicious.
Oh, maybe this isn't.
It might be the older version.
Oh yeah, probably is. Oh, here, wait. Don't worry, chat. I got you. Oh wait, never mind. It's that one closed down because I forgot that I crashed. Okay, well, we'll have pumpkins for the other one. We missed out. Sorry about
pumpkin
that.
Pumpkin now.
Oh wait, now try pumpkin. Okay, try the pumpkin one now.
Oh, hello.
Oh, hey. Looking good.
Pumpkin. Oh, that is a dead boy. Ah, yes. I no longer need to make a Halloween costume.
Sad boy, thank you for the follow.
Oh my god. Oh my god, my face.
At least I got pizza.
At least I got pizza.
Oh yeah.
And you said that, so this place specifically would be used just for like logics and just for people like build inside of here and to have like a good work environment, which I remember this was just like a blank white box before. So I definitely like the look of this a little bit more, and it has that a nice thing. Plus, it's a good like little area to see to talk inside of as well, just like to separate out.
Yeah, definitely. So that's why we have like our two different areas. A lot of people just kind of escape from people in the middle. And it's a place like this would be where you'd go work on something, or maybe work on your model and not have, you know, have to have people render everything. So just like pop over here, you know, get yourself situated without disturbing people. So you say music or whatever, people won't be able to actually hear whatever music you're playing in these zones either. Oh, you got to work, huh?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Oh no.
As your frames die.
I'm still looking pretty high. Anything above 10 is good for me. If you want, you could probably even since you spawned a Twitch chat in here, you have to tie that to your body for it to exist outside of this room. But if you want, you can you can bring the Twitch chat with you, and
I mean,
can, like,
you just hold it while going out. It's fine. It'll be fine.
Okay.
the windows seem the same to you, but they're getting a different shape.
Yep, no, I've embraced the dark side.
I think it's fog. I think they activated fog. Yeah. You get that extra spook, right?
So, by the way, that Twitch chat has a bro component in it related to emote caching.
Hmm?
Would you know anything about that, Brox? Or emote caching?
I'm sure what it means.
Oh, thanks, Will. Boops back.
But alright, if I can drag you guys back out to the mid-island, there's a few more things I want to show you.
Yeah, for sure. Oh, let me go back out with my third person perspective. There we go. Piece of candy. Okay.
It's literally with chat.
Oh, thanks, chat. Let's go. I love you, chat. Mwah, mwah, mwah. Love you so much.
So, I don't know how much you saw with the actual panel here. So, if you go to it and then you toggle the dome is logo. So the idea is, which is kind of like, you know, this is how we want to have this design. It can materialize and dematerialize. We wanted to have like things like events. So, like, say it starts raining, for example. We want to have it where you can hear like the rain hitting like a big structure above you. The glass on it, you actually see the rain kind of coming down the dome.
That'd be sick.
If it was raining, however, and you turn the dome off, what would end up happening is we would have particles start for the rain. I agree, Bean. So,
also, Uka, thank you for the follow. And no, sad boy, I am not giving Rukio a kiss. princess can give them a kiss. Aww.
There you go.
Isn't that sweet?
So if you open the dome while it's raining, particles start playing. We'll have like things like different materials. We'll make it look like
it's actually zooped out.
So things like different like things that we can do with the metallic and smoothness to make the floor actually look like it's wet. You've got like, the audio going, you've got particles going, you've got even more visuals so that we could kind of like adjust, help give that visualization that, hey, it's raining. And kind of just like relay that across whatever we can inside the map. Of course, it's all gonna, you know, if you want that to happen, it's local.
If not, you can just keep with it, it's hitting the dome. And
I really like that, and it has that kind of like, it's good. They always said this when it comes to like game design or anything of what you're having for experience with VR. Environments and the sounds that are in those environments really immerse you into that space, and having it adjust and shift and having the shadows and the lighting proper inside the world, it all makes out to that experience of really making you feel like I'm not wearing a virtual reality headset anymore. I feel like I've just entered into a different space. And that's exactly what you're wanting from the experience. And already we get like these kind of glimpses of what we have right now. And it's coming closer and closer to being what we truly all want to be. And I'm just so amazed to see people want to express out their creativity. And they're not limited by it either. You're not having to pay every single month in order to like have this content here or something like that. It's just stuff that's being built out for you guys, and he got Zeus. Also, Uka, thank you so much for the hostess stream, and Laz, thank you for that tier 1 subscription. Very kind of you guys. Welcome back, Rukio. Sorry about that.
Yeah, no problem. I just had to go speak to Zeus real quick. What's going on?
My chat is vicious as usual. They're vicious animals.
I see.
So, ravenous.
Amazing. the Twitch to in-game interactions are great. I love every aspect of them. It's fantastic.
It's imagine though once Neos does have like a more range of like people that does get out to, imagine how many people can benefit from just that alone. Yeah. Just like incorporating them for their Twitch chat commands for inside this game, for to play out for other games. And you know, later down the road, we're probably even going to be having a form of like that whole screen share type thing. That would be really amazing. Just be displayed out and play out games inside of here while interacting with people in VR.
No, I agree. Definitely can't wait for that. And this is what's why I enjoy Neo so much, especially as a on the streamer side of it. Just all that interactivity.
Vic says we need cheap trackers, people. Yes, we do need cheaper trackers, like full body tracking. Like right now, this setup for me costs $350. If we can get full body tracking to be like a range of like $150 or less than $200, I feel like that's going to be really nice for people that just want to have.
Definitely.
Who knows? We might even have better solutions for just the camera solution.
Mm-hmm.
Next, I want a fist bump, please. Oh, for sure. Boom. Fist bump. Boom.
You
boom.
Take out your camera. Your head is out.
But yeah. So, thanks. So, yeah. Thank you, Kaveva, too. Unless you want to fist bump me for the added effect. I think she's about to go to my Twitch chat, and on topic of interactions, Twitch can also like do things like for myself. We've got all these great commands, and I'm like, okay, well, how can I compete with all these awesome things that you guys are doing? So, I've had some really good friends help out with getting it where chat can actually redeem a fist bump, and what will put a fist that there you go manifests in front of me. I'm actually fist bump chat from within Neos.
Wow. Right? So you're actually giving chat a fist bump through.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Mm-hmm. Next shows their name.
Next level.
One other thing I want to give a shout out for in this area is I don't know if these fireflies aren't just kind of like a random particle system. So we're actually using CoduFan's WebSocket like weather system from the MMC.
Nice.
I was talking with them and getting set up, and he came by. Glory and Bean took the time to get it set up on their own server. So right now, the direction and speed of these particles are currently for what Copenhagen's wind speed and direction is. So some days it's going to be. It still has set to Copenhagen, So. We'll leave it there for now. So if it's like if it starts getting super windy or super fast, you'll see that reflected anytime there's a pulse during those times. So we're able to kind of like plug in things like that. Maybe we might have it where when it is like super windy and say the dome is open,
we can have like the leaves kind of like displaced and like kind of like rustle a bit more, and same with everything else, like our bushes and ferns and grass that are actively moving using displacement shader.
Yeah, and I'm in full support of you guys of building out more worlds and having more content here for Inside of Neos, because that's what we need more than anything, is just people working together collaboratively and just building out awesome worlds continually, and that's definitely what the Vibes team is doing. And who would you say is the biggest contributors that you have so far that are helping you out the most?
Outside of our team, or like all of the main people that are on that you want to just give a shout out even right now on stream for their efforts to put in. Sure, I mean majority of like the Vibes team, everybody is actively working. Even like desktop people, like you said earlier, like Shardy is in desktop, and you know, he was just kind of off doing the actual like building of all that in desktop. So you have the ability to, even with like the limitations of current desktop support, we can still like, get things done together and cohesively. On the credits board, it's just been great with other people, like I said, Komashiba and Gon giving us things like the ability to have their Mogoro machine in here is like fantastic, right? And then we've got like things like for models, since it's an actively in progress world that's being built around. So you got like things like Logix and the Meta Movie guys, for long as you use like their models and the world. It's honestly just like everybody in like the community is great. People come in here, they chill.
I think it's usually better to have it when stuff of people just freely and openly helping each other and making it, so then you can have more ideas come actualized for virtual space.
Oh, definitely. We've been having a lot of traffic from new players, and just being able to like be in our HQ and show them the like some of the features that we have in here. It's just people are just like, why would I ever want to go back to VR chat or insert other platform? We're getting that a lot this past week. A lot this past week.
I think the common thing of like when a VRC user comes to us here, they're like, either they don't like because they're not used to the controls immediately, and then they're like, oh wow, this is so different, so weird for me. But or there's that other variation of the group that comes in, they're like, whoa, this has so much more that I actually can do, and their brain just starts going over like how all this stuff they can do. But again, expanding brain. Yeah, like that sort of thing, just pop open a drink.
I think the biggest hurdle for most people is that you like it's hard to get into things by yourself because it's a lot.
A
lot of people don't like going into worlds and just talking to someone. Like, I actually respect the people who come in here and are like, hi, please help. And of course, I'm with them. Like, recently I had a Russian girl just join in here, and she was like at spawn, and I fly by and she's like in Russian, like, oh, hey, can you please help? And my heart just broke a little bit, and I was like, all right, come on, like, I don't like speaking Russian, but I just did it. I helped her get set up, and I really respect those people, but like a lot of people just log in, see the dash, and like are intimidated and log out. That's what I've been hearing a lot from people.
Yeah, and I promise you though, in about like less than 3 weeks' time, we're already going to be having all of that MTC experience get repolished out for the new UI, for like teaching news. Actually, let me actually show that on stream real quick for you guys of what we got progress-wise. Ryuvi has been helping out quite a bit.
World exclusive.
Yes.
Sergio, I'm so sorry for zoosing you. I could not resist using my power.
I love this. it's fine.
So, I was just laughing my ass off in the river while eating because you started to explain and you suddenly like bees explode.
So if you guys can see, right here we have like a whole next button with different icons that will be displayed out, and this is obviously not anywhere near completion, but it'll have a whole bunch of different interactivity and
Oh no. A
little bit in front of the camera there, Les.
Sorry, I didn't see you.
All good. But we'll be having this of different icons, and basically it's going to be a guided tutorial that can be right away in the beginning of Neos. And then you can also even spawn this out in any world. If a new user comes in, they're like, I don't know how, where the controls are, what to do. You can just show them kind of almost like a PowerPoint, like, oh yeah, you just do this, and this. And then you can guide them very easily. Because I think once that people understand basic controls inside of here, and once they realize like how fun it is to actually build your own worlds and do your own stuff in VR, I think it's like a thing that's, there's so many people that I feel would love this that still don't even know about Neos yet, and they would really make a like high benefit of them using it for seeing what the true, you know, creative individuals that I know are going to be in this platform. But just getting it prepared. And so
like, that's the issue with the current MTC world, that everything's just at once.
The current MTC, it hasn't been updated since January. So
and this is just like one by one. It's way better. That's how the community tutorial world basically works as well. So
Is Aegis still here?
I'm right here.
Could you actually bring in images of the new polished out in MTC, so then the stream can see and these guys can see it too?
We just had them here, didn't
we? No, that was the tutorial S type thing. But he has some like some images of like a new look, and it's gonna be a lot more optimized. And it visually is going to be more welcoming. Right now, I feel like the experience is too sterile. Just like how you guys have like plants inside this environment.
Yeah.
I feel like that can be like more welcoming. So we're going to be having like potted plants and different like, you know, bushes inside that experience. So that feels like more, you know, natural and human.
More,
and not like sterile space kind of feel. Because that's how it feels like when you
more homey.
Yeah, more homey.
Is that the word? Yeah. I really look forward to finish MGZL, then I'm gonna die, I can't get addicted to it. Really?
But again, the best thing that you guys can do here on chat, or anybody who's listening in right now, if you know about Neos and you have friends that you can hopefully show them around or get them interested inside of it, definitely try to bring them in. And that's the best thing to have it grow out, is just that one person tells their friend, they tell their friends, and then before you know it, there's just so many different unique people coming inside here. And we want to attract, you know, people that are like good and that really care about VR and are passionate about that specifically. And you know, I would much rather have 1,000 VR users that are nice and kind to each other than 10,000 people that are just rampant, just, you know, being all crazy and going all over the place, you know, on, you know, doing stuff that doesn't really pertain too much to anything.
I honestly love how our small community is just like very neighborly and friendly, and everyone kind of knows each other. It's really nice.
Yeah, it's definitely at that size right now, and I love knowing each and every single, like, I know everyone inside this room. Well, maybe a little bit for Rampa. I haven't really talked to him too much.
And again, something like that.
Four says, I'm getting my VR this weekend and bringing a friend along with me. Hopefully they get into it. Nice. Awesome. Sounds good, Four.
Looks like it's just bringing some stuff in here.
Only full screen, and I shouldn't have done that. There we go. And that's. Man, screenshot would be so nice.
Ooh, yeah. I like the look of that so far.
I like the trees.
Right? Yeah.
That's actually where a Skybox section would go.
Yep, but you can see right here there's these waterfalls and potted plants that would be right there.
Waterfalls, you have my attention.
Yeah!
Freaking idea.
Hell yeah.
Spec says, Neos has been friendly since I first got in and it stayed that way. Yep, people here are very kind. Yeah, and there's also going to be like this area that will be a lot more like, we wanted it to feel like a lot more like a streamlined experience, just, you know, getting that all polished up, making it more fresh and making it so that it runs much, much better than our current one. Is going to be a really good update for it, and is going to make the new users that come inside of here feel very welcomed. I promise you, 2021 Neos is going to be the time when we actually do have it properly set up for new users. 100%, I think so. And there's going to be so many more additional updates. Optimizations are going to be so much better inside of Neos by that point. I would say it's going to be even triple the amount of stuff that you'll be able to do inside of Neos and still be running at a high frame rate.
I'm excited for it.
I currently
have 12 people in here, and I'm getting, albeit some of the effects going on, but my frame rate's still running pretty good. Oh, look at that. It looks looking clean.
You're a fan. Dovis says, I'm glad I'm here early. Yep, technically we're all here early. This is very early for all of this sort of stuff.
Yeah, it is technically very, very early.
Yep.
Yeah, for me too. Same time.
I mean, real consumer VR has only really been out since like 2016, so... Two main reasons why I went to Niels. I got disgusted by what is happening in VRC2. I can do all the stuff in Unity and trust systems to stop me from doing stuff. Yes. Understandable. I like that I don't have to ever touch Unity again, personally. Well, I mean, I still have to touch Unity sometimes, but not in the way that I had to. I can do a lot more stuff just... Plus, you can't work collaboratively instead of Unity. It's very hard to just...
You can just make other users do the work you don't like.
I think that's the biggest thing for me, is being able to collab with a whole bunch of people and just like have systems working, being worked on. Different areas of the map working, and then you can just tie things up together, and all that time is just like double, right? You have all of it doubled. You have it's like Zyzel, for example, was working on like the day night cycle, and then shortly after, assets that we started bringing in and making was all tied to that. So it was at that point in time, it was okay. This is at a state where we can tie things to it. Other things that we're also setting up from other people building things, and then bam, we just simple dynamic variable plug and play. Oh, is this what we're doing now? Yeah. Someone zoos me with their own thing.
People are climbing onto you. Other things that you can do inside of Neos.
I'm squelching while spinning.
There we go.
What is that sound effect?
That is her walking.
Oh no.
Have you shown them the lazy bear index? He's dead. So yeah, we've got a lazy river. And you can just get your body into in case we haven't.
Just keep breathing.
You haven't seen.
Just,
You're so tiny and small.
Oh my god.
You as well, Queen Abby. Hello. And you have spoon. Big spoon.
Oh my god.
For all the cereal and soup. Oh.
Comically
more cereal and soup.
I'm so sorry for making you stream curse. Am I in front of the camera or something?
Yeah, that's okay. I type into YouTube Neos VR for this week, and then it's like, oh, recommended. Neos VR is cursed. Oh, thanks, YouTube.
That's gonna be my fault. That's like all on me. You can just say Laz made Neos curse. Oh my god.
I've had a few people were asking me to consider doing like YouTube content, because I feel like Neos YouTube content is kind of lagging.
It is.
So I don't know. At some point after this move, I might go as far as look into like editing like clips and moments of Neos, or just like interesting bits and slapping together. Like,
we were doing that for the streams a little bit. It's just sometimes we only have those for like very specialty streams, or like streams that are like, I feel like really, really important to like show off or have like key things that, an archive type thing. But for most of the time, if it's just like hangout streams, like what we're doing right now, kind of, I mean, you can have some clips from here, like when we, like those funny parts or stuff like that.
Yeah, no.
I'm definitely going to clip that thing that happened to Rukia.
Oh, there you go. Stuff like this is great.
Imagine also being able to record inside of here just using like the Neos cam, but without having even no OBS whatsoever. It just like exports out like a video format file or that sort of thing, so people could use it.
Oh, that'd be pretty interesting.
Awesome. Right? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Let's say 69% on your wrist.
Oh, that's for my heart monitor.
Nice. Mm-hmm. Nice.
But I don't have my heart monitor on right now.
69%. Oh, that's why.
Nice. Get out of here, Beanie. You have a dirty mind.
I just said nice.
Oh my gosh.
But yeah, so this is our
I'm using 69% of my heart.
Oh no, that's probably not a. That's probably not good.
If I was, then I'd be dead.
Yeah. But yeah. So this is our headquarters. This is what we kind of put some time into after MMC.
So yeah.
That way we want to build out our systems, like a day-night cycle, and just be easily able to go to any map in the future that we build. We want day-night, bah, smack that bad boy in. And then it's so much easier.
Are we going to also have a human cannon?
I think we were talking about like parts stuff at some point, and I think like
human cannons.
To shoot people out of cannons was on a
human was on cannon is needed.
Exactly. He can't shake me off. I'm sticky.
So, I'm gonna ask chat if we have also any more questions for possibly Rukio or anyone else that's here. Please ask away, you guys, because we definitely love answering your questions here for any of us. And also. If you haven't already joined already, definitely join inside of our Discord, discord.gg/NeosVR, where you can learn more about Neos and join inside of this growing and expanding metaverse for more things to come and more things to see and content such as what Rukia and everyone else, Queen Heidi, Toxcookie, more individuals that are on the list on the content. I guess I could just go over right here and lay it out for credits. Got Queen Heidi, Zyzel, Beaned, Vigilbu, Jenna, Gory, Arctic Game Princess, Shorty, Alex from Alaska, Chi, Kodu Fan, Hey It's Nate, Creator Jam, and
Gone 3 Komashiba. Yeah,
Gone 3 Komashiba. So, all the credits for you guys. You guys are awesome.
I don't know. Next, it's just great, like seeing, Gina just made a boxing of the air hockey, and then a modelers, in this case Princess, came along, saw that it was just the boxes, and in the span of like 30 minutes, we had a mesh custom for like our groups for air hockey. So just being able to do things like that, just have a proof of concept and then make it an actual proper system is completely great. Between like the logics side and the building side of things is just amazing.
Wow, you got that nice dab on stream there, Bean. But yeah, thank you again so much for showing out this awesome place in this world. We'll be hanging out inside here just for a few more minutes, and then we're going to be going into like other worlds that are like some spooky Halloween maps of like previous years of Neos, and kind of like the older worlds just to see like what it was back then, and you know. And but it's nice to see the brand new though of what's coming into Neos and what we can have for interactivity, and as well as just a cool little Halloween style world, which I'm sure you're going to be having a this world more decked out for when it gets closer to Halloween, to where people can just come inside here and vibe as usual.
No, hell yeah.
Yeah, boy.
And don't worry, next. We'll also be working on our horror map at some point, too.
Are you talking about Disney World?
Disney World.
Oh no. I am not going to be showcasing that off on stream, that's for sure. But, you know, it was worth a shot. Sup, Arctic? Nice to have you here. Here, I'll remove these images out.
But yeah.
Thanks so much for coming out.
Yeah, thanks so much for coming out to our pub, pretty much.
Oh, no problem. I mean, thank you for, you know, having me and having our chat here.
Oh, definitely.
This racks by the fire a little bit.
Asterisk lays down on couch.
Asterisk, yeah. Hey, you don't have to do asterisks anymore, you can just actually do it.
No, but, wait, Hiri, don't do that. No. Wait.
I would love to eventually also get into doing out, once we have it set up for the Neos headquarters, possibly for next month, really finding different people for podcasts and doing podcast style stuff.
Interesting.
Yeah, because we have the camera controls for, like, side. And then it can be, like, more focused and, like, it could be more of, like, but I feel like we would want specific people that are, like, really big in VR to, like, have on to the podcast to just inquire them about VR and just basically talk about tech and talk about other fun stuff. Sure. Yeah, Neo's really talk show type thing. Yeah.
It's like
yeah, I think we're all big in VR. Yeah.
Skin
mode
being restricted.
I mean,
yeah, just stay big. Stay big, Bean.
But I mean, that'd be a pretty good idea. Just
talk about tech or talk about, like, the current things that are being worked on. In this case, it
well,
could be, you know,
no, I was access. Meaning like those could be like even side stream. Like usually we talk about stuff that's being worked on, like the Friday streams. Like that one would be specifically of almost like an interview or just having somebody on like a podcast style thing and just talking about, you know, inquiring them about stuff or like inquiring them of how they could also like benefit from using out Neos and what they could be using for their own projects or their own stuff of what they might be using it for. But just in very thinking those kind of people, I was actually thinking who might be a really good group of people to interview is VR Exorcist and their mate, because they're right now setting up a whole entire thing for an in-world concert.
No.
So, what? No memes on the camera, you guys. No memes. Oh my gosh.
What do you mean?
But, yeah, having them on and just talking to them about and interviewing them about how they're using Neos, because right now they actually want to make it for, like, pre-recording stages that are live, and they were even doing, like, real cutouts of them using a green screen behind them. And it was basically looking like a PNG image of them, like, moving around, and she was, like, singing on the stage. It was really incredible to see something like that and to see see them live. Them right there in front of you, and it had an amphitheater kind of sound going on around it.
What is that above us?
I don't know. It's alright, we're not saving this version of this.
Amicus!
Bean, what happened to your lips? What happened to your lips, Bean?
I can't save it.
Oh.
Oh, 1 second, Aegis, I got your back. There you go. Enjoy.
Hold on. Let me just contribute to this real quick. Same energy.
I guess you have to find your happy place.
Same energy.
This is my happy song.
Yeah. Hold on. I mean, I don't know. I'm excited going forward.
It's just like this.
It's like tech that allows us to.
Are you going
to
be getting one of those haptic suits once we get them integrated?
I'm tempted. The thing that I have my eyes on currently would be eye tracking with the index.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Just so I can take up my, immersion of my character to another level.
Yeah, you'll be able to really feel the Zeus. I know for sure the consumer models of the Tesla suit are coming around like 2023. So by that point, when they start making consumer models, yeah, we'll hopefully start integrating that fully out. And then, you know. So 3 years from now, you know, if you save up and if they're like $800, you know, or maybe even less. Actually, I think that they want them to be around the price of like a console. So, where consoles usually go for nowadays, like $600, $500.
Like $499 or something.
Yeah, $499. I would imagine it'd probably be like $599 if they're really gonna sell it out.
What the fuck is this?
Mr. Whitley says $400 to $500. Yeah, that could be a good estimate, or like, or well, he was talking about for how much like consoles usually are. Yep, that's where they want to get it out for the Tesla suits, right. And that full body haptic suit for full body tracking and for sensations that you can feel on your body, it'd be pretty intense for VR. We could actually be standing in front of this fireplace and feel the warmth of it. You'd feel actually warm, your body would get warm.
Hopefully with a clamp on that, I wouldn't want to get too warm.
Oh yeah, no. I'm sure that you can make adjustments for it, and even have like when we integrate it on our side, we'll probably even have it to where it doesn't go past this point, even if it like wanted to. Like you could say, oh yeah, this might be too.
I think it might be hardware
based. You can adjust intensity.
That's kind of limits.
Yeah.
But I don't think the suit would be too hot for you to where it would be like it burns you in a way or something like that.
Yeah.
But it, I did hear it is pretty intense though with the cold and the heat, because they do train like firefighters with the suit on.
Oh really?
Uh huh.
Yeah, firefighters, soldiers. It's been like bought up like crazy by the military.
The
lately.
Military has been buying each suit at around $10,000 a pop.
Oh my god.
So, because they love it for training. It's the best thing for training right now is VR. Specs is gonna sit by the fire and cook some hot pockets in my Tesla suit. Hey, just be sure to bake the hot pockets and not just throwing them in the microwave. Trust me, they taste so much better when you bake them. Oh yeah.
You may as well go out and grill them.
I don't think that would taste too
good.
Have you ever grilled your hot pockets before?
I've not, but you give me ideas now.
Oh my god.
Alright, make a video about it.
Take it to the next level, egg wash them.
Egg wash?
Yeah, you know, dip them in like an egg wash and then bake them that way. I don't know, maybe even like roll them in breadcrumb.
Egg wash,
then breadcrumb, and then deep fry them. It means to dip them in egg.
You grab an egg and you mix it. And then you take a brush, you dip the egg in with the brush, and then you lather it on it just very lightly.
It's short.
I was very thinking like egg wash was like, it's like the water, the leftover water after you boil an egg or something.
I
sometimes just want to have like an inner visual of like the things that go on in Yurikyo's head.
What was that one?
And then you see it, and it's just like a little man just trying to like operate all these like screws and gears, but a lot of them just like have like cobwebs on them, and he's just like.
I wonder what's happening inside his head.
Egg dirt water.
Egg dirt water. So you take this egg water on the...
I love eggs so much. Eggs are delicious.
Damn. But that with like melted cheese?
Yes. Actually, favorite way to enjoy eggs is either eggs with bacon or eggs with like a burrito. Like an egg burrito with like the salsa.
Dude.
And like you're having like the pico de gallo.
Yeah. Like, it's gotta be like a good burrito though. There's a lot of places you go to get like an egg like breakfast burrito, and you taste more tortilla than say
anything.
Like egg or yeah, exactly. It's just you're eating flatbread the entire time. There's no.
Well, yeah, you make it at home. That's so easy. All you have to do is at Costco they have these tortillas. That are inside their... What? You don't like those ones, Princess? You don't like tortillas?
I don't like store-bought tortillas. I like homemade tortillas.
Homemade tortillas are great. These ones taste basically just like the homemade tortillas, though. That's why I like the ones from Costco, because those ones are actually still the raw ones. They have them still raw, so you have to, like, cook them. Once you cook them up, they taste raw. Yeah, no. It's just the raw dough. They basically are using the same stuff that you'd use if you were to make homemade tortillas as well. Because, yeah, homemade tortillas are obviously the best route, but sometimes people, they just don't have enough time. But if you buy the ones that are from Costco, those ones are like the raw ones. Those ones taste great with a breakfast burrito. And then just throw eggs inside there, some diced up tomatoes, cilantro, onions, salsa.
Oh, you get the cilantro.
Yeah.
Cilantro? The cilantro's great.
Cilantro takes over
flavor in general.
Oh no, I think it adds in compliments. I love cilantro.
Maybe you dip your cilantro in egg water or whatever it was.
Egg wash. Chat's now complaining. I don't think we should talk about food anymore. They're all like,
they either
want us to now have a cooking stream, or we're just making them hungry. So.
We'll get on interactive cooking.
We'll just get Guy Fieri or Gordon
Ramsay. Welcome to Cooking with Beans here live at the Vibes HQ.
Cooking.
We don't eat cilantro anymore. Oh, thanks. Oh, thank you. You hear that stream? Ooh, delicious sizzling meats. Ooh. Vegans have left the chat. No vegans here.
I'm sorry.
Sorry, vegans.
I'm looking hella sophisticated now with this coffee.
Oh, yeah.
Hell yeah.
Mmm.
What was it? It was egg wash, what you said. Okay.
Imagine a cooking show with Rukio that ends up like the how-to basic. Oh yeah.
I feel like this would probably end up like... Sorry, just take this egg wash.
How to peel a potato with Rukio.
Probably with like a half potato gone.
How to peel a banana with Rukio.
I can definitely nail that one.
How to set your circle on fire.
I think I've burnt water once.
Burnt water?
It's tomato steak. Oh, yeah, we better get this meat off. It's getting pretty done here.
A little bit longer.
No. I like my medium rare. Get out of here, that.
No, it's just ready.
Yeah, you gotta flip it. That's all you gotta do.
I gotta flip it? Okay.
Yeah, you just gotta flip it.
ASMR, you guys. Sizzle.
ASMR, you said. Alright, I'll stop whispering now.
You're out in the park with your friends, grilling, enjoying a nice conversation.
You think my chips is almost ready?
Okay.
This can mean.
Chicken. Why is the chicken alive, though? Disturbing!
Soon won't be anymore.
Oh.
No. Whoa, pumpkinified! Ah! I got pumpkinified. Thanks, chat.
Oh, look, it's... The meat is just ready. Look, it's just ready for you.
Oh, wow, thank you. Nom nom nom. Thank you, delicious.
Is it charcoal,
I can't see! I can't see, chat. How could you do this? My gosh.
The guest before.
They say charcoal is good for your teeth, though.
I already have enough carbon.
What is it?
That's beans. That's beans.
I love how he has just the pizza in her mouth and just looks so.
With those set of teeth, he's certainly a carnivore. I love me some meat.
You want some?
I think I have enough carbon.
No, it's good for your teeth.
That's why I love the paleo diet, because the paleo diet, I get to eat as much meat as I want. It's great.
It's one heck of a diet.
As well as macadamia nuts. Macadamia nuts are so expensive, though. They're like ridiculously priced.
Are they? What do they run for?
Like, are they?
Like, a bag of macadamia nuts is like $25.
What?
How do they sell them? Are the ones at Subway just fake then? Because they have macadamia nuts.
They're probably the bad ones. Like, the bad quality ones. You want a macadamia nut? You want them to be like about that big. Like, pretty. You want them to be like fat, and if you bite into them, they'll have almost like a buttery flavor. Like, they'll be very buttery. Wait,
yeah, then the one at Subway are probably the bad ones.
Yeah.
F-A-T or P-H-A-T?
Say the what?
What's
it would be funny to have like a fight like, spoon versus
a fat F-A-T.
Okay.
Yes. But yeah, usually you'll tell if the nut is like really dry and it's like then you know that's a low it's a low quality mac and cheese. If it's dry.
It's so out of context.
If the nut is dry, it's not good. But if the nut is moist,
oh my god,
Bean,
are you gonna like stop time now or something?
That's
a
so what?
I unmuted right at the if the nut is dry. I love you guys so much. Oh my gosh.
I unmuted right as I heard and I heard.
Yeah. 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 Oof. Oof indeed.
Is that water?
Mm-hmm. I need more. Wait. I'm not gonna. Oh, okay. I need more macadamia. Macadamia. That's.
They're very good for you. Very healthy.
These are my feathers.
Are they? They sound like it'd be like a superfood or something.
Yeah, macadamia nuts have a very good fat content, and they fuel your body. They're good energy. They'll turn you into a macadamia nut zombie. You'll be energized like Bean.
I'm a bird.
Renari, oh gosh. Renari says, this is why I mute because I can't have my work call hear this in the background. Oh, sorry, Renari.
Yeah, these aren't done yet. Just gonna keep,
Okay. So, thank you again so much, Rukio, and Princess and Laz, and Queen Heidi, and everyone else that's here. Bean.
Hello, I am everyone else. Just,
thank you for being a bird on stream.
I'm also everyone else.
I just had to flip outside and listen for a moment. Did I miss something?
Thanks for coming out to Raid HQ. I'm gonna nuke this version of it.
Sounds good to me. We're gonna be checking out the next Halloween world for you guys just for a little bit on stream, and then we're gonna be ending off the stream once we're done showing off a few of the Halloween worlds. We'll spend just like a couple minutes in each one. But thank you again so much, Rukio. It was a pleasure, and now you can go back to sleep and rest until the pound of doom. Boom!
Hell yeah, dude.
You guys are amazing.
Thanks for coming to chat with us.
You really love me!
Yep, I'll chill with you guys later on, once I'm sure when you wake up. Bye-bye! Au revoir.
Yeah,
peace to you guys. Cool. You like to join Aegis? Sweet. Starting up
like
the session. I'll take one of these meat products with me. Thank you.
Going to sleep?
Okay. So this Halloween world that was done out was by Turk, called The Lost Woods, and we got this as a featured out place. We actually watched some Nightmare Before Christmas inside of here, so that was pretty fun, which I really enjoyed that. We're planning on also watching The Corpse Bride and Coraline, hopefully later on as well, which that should be fun, watching some movies inside of here. But obviously we can't do that on stream. Don't get lost. Click for credits. Credits go to Grass is by Vegas X did out the grass, table, cabin, table chairs, and fountain. Turk did the design, logics, graveyard, planks, and poles. Electric by trees. Bean did candles. Purple Juice did ghosty in the barn. Dr. Frank did the sword, Cal did the campfire, Zane did the audio, and emotional support was Doki, Moki, and Bigelboo, and Earth, Mark, Galaxy, and Ryuvi. Very nice. And yeah, Coraline is a pretty good movie. I'd say out of all of the Tim Burton movies, that one's probably my favorite, for considering it's like a children's film, but it gets very dark. Also, if you look into the books on that, the books I hear a lot scarier for that, and they didn't include some stuff that was pretty creepy. But this environment also a very creepy feeling, and I don't even know where Aegis went, and that's even make me more uncomfortable. Aegis, where'd you go? Oh, there you are. You got to stay by my side. Otherwise, we'll get lost. Here, let's go out this way. I believe that just teleports you around or teleports you back. So basically, it's kind of like an infinite loop. So really, you just keep like going and going and going. Oh, well, actually, he just went out there, but I don't see him anymore. Here, let's try to go again. Huh. Let's go back. Oh. This is something that's different. I haven't seen this before. What path should I take, you guys? There's so many different paths. I feel like there's gonna be like a jump scare. Which I am not ready for. Let's try to go down here. Oh. I don't know where to go, you guys. Oh, what the heck is that sound? You guys hear that? I feel like the deeper that I go, the creepier it gets. I don't like the sounds. Now go left? Okay. Oh no. I don't like that. No, 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 no. Ah! Why is there mushrooms here? What the fuck? What the fuck just happened? I got teleported randomly. I know, Aegis. I don't know what's going on here. Oh, look, there's Icy. Icy's just teleporting right here. Oh, no, no. Never mind. They're just coming into the world, but it's just like they're all right here. Whoa, this is cool. I didn't even know that this stuff was here. Aegis, like, I'm trying to get to Nex. Who's funding Nex's funeral? Yo, this place is really cool, though. I like the floating, it feels like Alice in Wonderland with the whole, like, floating chairs and mushrooms. Should we keep exploring, you guys? We also got this happy flower. Okay. No jump scares yet. Dova, probably guide me out. Where should I go? Keep going around? Okay. I'm gonna go this way. Okay, well, we're back here. Oh no, you guys. Let's keep going. Dig down. Let's go left side again. Oh, what the heck? This is different too. I think we're at the graveyard. Oh! What the fuck? I don't like it. I keep hearing sounds. You're 69% heart rate. Aegis, don't sneak up on me like that, boy. Hear you breathing. Okay.
Oh, you heard me breathing.
Yes. Here, which way do you want to go, Aegis?
I don't know. Last time I tried following you, it just teleported me.
You know, let's follow the light. I feel like we should follow the light.
I just turned that on.
Oh, you just turned that on.
Yep.
Okay, well, still, we'll go this way. Maybe it's a sign. another variant of the graveyard, but I think me and Aegis got separated again. So if you come in here with friends, you're probably going to get lost very quickly. Maybe random till you get back to the original. Okay, let's go. Okay, I think I'll go forward. Okay, that didn't seem to do too much for me. Maybe go on the left side again. Maybe left again. To the left, to the left. What happens if you keep just going in a straight line? Here, let me try that. I'll keep going in a straight line. Well, we're back in the Alice in Wonderland. Let's keep going in a straight line. Oh, Alice in Wonderland again. I think we just keep coming back to the Alice in Wonderland. I think it switches out through, Hey, you just...
May I startle you again?
Welcome to the Mad Hatter Party. Everybody...
Indeed.
Well, let's see here. We got some Utah teapots. Nice.
Right?
I like that detail.
Roxy Boxy, thank you so much for the Tier 1 subscription.
It's a purple one, too.
Would you like to eat a mushroom, Aegis? One pill makes you... larger, one pill makes you small, and the ones that mother gives you don't do anything at all. There you go.
Done.
Enjoy.
It's shroom.
I'm being shroomified, you guys. Ah. Wow.
Oh, make it to your
tiny
level.
Man!
Well,
here there we go. Now I'm at your level.
I'm just off-mirroring a display so then you guys can actually see the color effects that it shows.
What sick man sends babies to fight?
Yeah, basically like taking LSD. My gosh.
Oh, hey, Roo.
Hello, how y'all doing?
Nice to see you, Roo.
I can't climb, Ro.
Still streaming?
Yep, we are still streaming, nice. Showing off some Halloween-style worlds. Nice to see Electronus. Nice to have you here, too. We're going to be ending off the stream, though, in pretty soon. Pretty soon. We're probably going to be going to another world after this one, just one more, and then we'll be ending off the stream.
Yeah.
Probably after these effects wear off. I think it was cake. It's been a long time since seen the movie. Once is over, come eat this. Yeah.
He gave me one, and I gave him one.
One side of the mushroom makes you larger, and one side of the mushroom makes you small. That's what caterpillar said. Pat, pat. Oh, and look at a random Darius peering behind the trees. Darius. He just runs away. Well, there you go. Okay, so we're going to be checking out another place again, and this world is called the Lost Woods, and pretty cool place to get yourself lost in for Halloween. Mm-hmm. I definitely like that.
There's a lot of rooms too.
I haven't found the one that had like the cabins yet.
Oh yeah, I've been there once.
Yeah.
Let us check out. We'll end off this stream for this Halloween's weekend. Showing off for you guys a spooky, scary skeleton world by Gearbell that was made out for last year. Because that one's a pretty funny one.
And sex. Sex is busting that move again.
See, if I was dead, this is what I'd be doing. Just dancing with my graveyard buddies. Yeah.
I am dead, look.
Oh yeah, zero heart rate. There you guys go. You got the moves too.
If I had full body, I'd dance, but...
Fair enough.
All I can do is move my arms.
Oh, there you go, Electros. Spooky, scary skeletons. Rory says, oh, is this using the new animation system from the MSC? No, actually, this is just a regular animation. Just an OG.
From, like,
just
a,
an
OG.
Yeah,
just
a... Yep. Pretty sure it's Mixamo. This is that default Mixamo, dancing. Let's see if I can try to articulate it.
Is my voice doing
I really cannot do right do now? That one. Pierce is like, I'm proud of you for trying. Yeah.
You can grab them!
Yeah, you can grab onto them. Ah!
Wait, come here, you.
Oh no. poor scary skeleton. But yeah, this, for last Halloween, this was my favorite place to, just, relax in, for Halloween time, which it's kind of funny because it's, You know, I remember.
So
oh, what are you doing,
then.
Boy? No.
Yes.
That is horrible.
It's a fractal.
What is this even?
Oh no! 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 More.
Oh no! God, this is creepy.
Now this is Halloween content.
Oh my gosh.
Yes, indeed. Skeleton fan. Okay, hold on. Let me just,
Oh gosh. Hello, Ruth.
There we go.
Hello.
And friends.
Chicken dance.
Infinite dimension of skeleton. Fractal skeleton. Skeleton fractals.
Okay. So, thank you again so much, you guys, for watching this Neos VR stream. We're going to be having a longer one for next week because we're going to be streaming out the whole Neos party that we're going to be having on Friday. And obviously on Saturday it's going to be, or next Saturday it's going to be Halloween. And for the 30th we're also going to be celebrating Frox's birthday. So definitely be joining us for that stream. It's going to be a big stream. We're going to be showing off all the different stuff that we're going to be having here inside of Neos for the party. And as well as just hanging out, listening to music, and celebrating Frox's birthday on the 30th. And we're going to be streaming out for probably longer. That one's going to be a longer stream, maybe at least like 3 hours or so. But again, we'll be continually having these streams every week on Fridays. And thank you guys again so much for watching for today. And I hope you have an amazing Friday. And just have fun. Get something good to eat. Get some water. And, you know... get more people here inside of Neos, and if you want to join us for that party for next week, please let us know, and we'll get you a slot to be inside of there. And we're going to be having it all on a headless server. Some people, if it gets too unoptimized, we'll probably have people swap into an avatar that is like a 2D, like some spooky ghost kind of characters, or some other type of character that's like flat, and people can interact with and still talk with at the environment, so... Dova says, I'll be there, I'll be aiming. Cool. Yep, we want to have a lot of people at the party. So definitely please join us for that. And as always, please just let other friends know about Neos and bring them inside of here. And stay spooky this week, you guys. Bye-bye. Mm-hmm. Wave goodbye to the camera, everyone. Au revoir.